Now, winning one championship is hard. Going back-to-back is really hard. And turning that into a three-peat, well, it's nearly impossible.
But on the weekend, and in hostile territory, the Breakers did just that to secure the Australian National Basketball League title for the third year in a row, only ever been done once before. Well, with us is swingman Tom Abercrombie and assistant coach Dean Vickerman. Good morning, gentlemen. Fantastic to have you in with us this morning after what must have just been a massive weekend for you. Has it sunk in yet?
It's getting there. It has been a real whirlwind of a few days, flying all the way back from Perth, that took a whole day, and it seems to have just been one thing after another since we got back, but it's been an absolutely fantastic ride, and we're enjoying every moment of it. These things don't happen every day, so it's been great.
We see the celebration at the time out on the court.
The pitch.
out on the court, and we saw Dylan with a sort of celebratory throw. But when you guys got back into the changing room, when you could be yourselves again as a unit, I mean, Dean, what was the mood like then? What was going through the team at that stage?
Yeah, it was pretty calm this time, and you know, obviously when the media came in, you know, we played up to it a little bit and things, but everyone was exhausted. You know, Dylan was absolutely exhausted, and Cedric's exhausted. And I guess you would just kind of sit back and try and absorb, you know, what we've just achieved, and it's still going to take a while to do that.
Tom, talk us through the atmosphere over there, because we were talking in the break about just how hard it is to win in Perth. I mean, a lot of people were secretly hoping that you'd win back here in Auckland, but you're so glad to get it out the way.
Yeah, absolutely, and it was a very hostile environment over there, and so loud that I can't remember whenabouts in the game it was, but when Lish and Dazza got into that little scuffle and Cedric had to step up to the free throw line after that, I've never heard a stadium so loud, and you know, it felt like the whole place was shaking. But it's pretty cool feeling to be able to use that to motivate us and to keep them quiet at the end of the day. So you know, winning in a place like that is something pretty special.
And talk us through your personal celebrations, because I know you're at Sky City with a lot of the public, but then last night you guys just got together as a team, is that right?
Yeah, we just had our own little team celebration last night, which was really cool. Like I said before, it has been a very busy few days for us to be able to sit down as a team and just you know, sit back and enjoy it and take it all in. Was a good moment.
Was there anything in you that said, actually, it would have been quite nice to have seen this go to a third game for the home crowd to win at home? But no, you just wanted to get it done.
No, we wanted to get it done. And to be able to do it on the road, something pretty cool. And you know, the first year we did it at North Shore, and last year at Vector. And this year, to be able to do it on the road is another experience altogether. And we talked about the challenge before the game of being able to win a championship on someone else's floor. It doesn't get any harder than that, and that really motivated us before the game, and we use that to our advantage.
Dean, can you talk us through, I mean, everyone tries to work out what is so special about the Breakers, and I know, as being a sports reporter, you go to Breakers trainings and all of the players are so nice and everyone is willing to give interviews, which is quite different to other sporting teams. Yeah. But from your perspective, what is it that makes this team special? Is it the guys? Is it their personalities? Or what is it?
Yeah, I guess as a coach, the first thing you want to do is recruit great people. And I think we've been very good at just really selecting the personalities that fit our club and fit our values of the club. And, you know, and then it's, you know, it's not pushed in your face or anything like that. It's just about, you know, doing the right thing. And if you're not doing the right thing, you'll be held accountable by your teammate, by your coach, or by someone else in the club. And it's easy to do it. And I'm sure you've found us just easy to work with. And it's a great club.
Yes, a lot of teams could learn a lot from you guys. You reconvene basically in August. It's going to be a slightly different look. A few players who are obviously stepping down, looking at moving maybe back home, and also the coach situation. So, I mean, what do you think will be in place? I mean, Dean, do you see Andre going back to Australia and you stepping up?
Well, you know, we're a club that always, if someone's got an opportunity to progress himself, you know, we want to see him do that. If, you know, Tom got to go to the NBA, or Cedric got to go to the NBA, we say, great, good luck to you. We hope you come back to us one day. Andre's exactly the same. If he can get the Boomers job and be an Olympic coach, you know, that's great for him. You know, and if it happens, it happens, and we'll see, you know, who takes that role afterwards.
But you'd certainly want the role, wouldn't you?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, you know, I've been assistant in this league for 10 years now and won four championships, and so you want to take on the next challenge.
And meanwhile, Tom, NBA? It's the big dream.
Fingers crossed.
It's every basketball player's dream, awesome. But long way to go before then.
For sure. Thank you so much for coming in, guys. Amazing trophy. We hadn't
it
mentioned
sure
that.
Is. Just sitting Thank there. You for just bringing that in. We might have to get a wee photo with that. Hey, congratulations too. And I hope you guys have more celebrations to come. And like I said, I've worked with you guys for a few years now. An awesome team. You're a pleasure to work with.
Thank you very much.
Very quickly, something I was thinking about last night is, where do you get the motivation? You know, one, to win it, twice to defend it, three, to win a third, equal the record, and to win overseas. Now, the momentum, of course, is to set the all-time record, isn't it? It's a big goal, isn't it?
It is. You know, Sydney went to that fourth grand final, and unfortunately myself and Daryl Coletto were on the Tigers team that knocked him off.
Yeah.
So, a fourth would be unbelievable.
Extraordinary. Fantastic. Thank you, guys.